After Pearl Harbor, America needed warriors like never before. But Kennedy remained at safe remove in naval intelligence. When he finally, with the help of family connections, landed an assignment to train with a new combat unit, PT boats, he pronounced himself delighted.
Now, you know, PT boats were known as the bucking broncos of the Navy because they're very light-hulled and they skim so fast over the waves so that each wave is a bounce, each wave is a jolt. The man who served with us said he was always in pain.
This was rough service, and it was terrible on his back. Nevertheless, he perseveres and gets assigned to the Southwest Pacific, which is where the action is, fighting the Japanese.
Kennedy arrived in the Solomon Islands in the spring of 1943 and took command of a 56-ton attack boat, PT-109. He liked his 12-man crew, but was unimpressed by the higher-ups.
He was a very junior officer out in the Pacific. He was on the margins of the war, but he saw how a military operated, not from the top down, but from the bottom up. And one of his favorite expressions was, the military screws up everything.
PT-109 skipper did little to distinguish himself in his first 4 months on duty. He and his men ran raids on Japanese supply convoys. They were shot at, and they fired back, but steered clear of major incident. Until a hot, starless night that August. Out on a routine mission, Kennedy had his vessel idling in open water when a Japanese destroyer emerged out of the darkness, racing at 40 knots, and split his boat in half. Two of his crewmen were killed immediately. It took Kennedy nearly 3 hours, swimming around in the dark, to gather the survivors onto what was left of his PT boat. His engineer, Pappy McMahon, was badly burned, in excruciating pain, and helpless. They were still stranded in open water at daybreak. Mid-afternoon, what was left of PT-109 was beginning to sink, and it looked like they had been left for dead.
They're drifting, holding onto the hull and drifting in the water when he sees a group of islands about 3 miles off. He tells them they have to swim to it to survive, but how is McMahon going to swim? McMahon is wearing a life jacket. Kennedy takes one of the straps, cuts it, puts one end in his teeth, tells McMahon to lay on his back, and then he tows him the 3 miles to this island. And when he gets up on the beach, he collapses. The men who were with Kennedy that day, they all speak of his sense of responsibility, that it was his job, that he would spare no effort to try and get help for his crew.
It took a week, but Kennedy did manage to get his crew rescued. Fortunately, he wrote to his father, they misjudged the durability of a Kennedy. He made it out alive a few months later, sent stateside for medical reasons. And when he arrived at his parents' winter home in Palm Beach, his weight was down to around 120. His back was so bad, he needed a brace and a cane to walk. But he was also a war hero. The Navy had made a public display of putting two medals on his bony chest. And the story of PT-109 made great copy. Read by millions.